Hello friends, I'm Sarah Rose, and in today's video I will be showing you the new Reeves watercolor 24-piece set, as well as a demo of that set. But first, I want to give you guys a month recap of what I've been up to over the month that I haven't posted on YouTube. So I thought I would just show you some Instagram stories and stuff that you might have missed. So over this month, I've just had a bunch of schoolwork, and it's been kind of stressing me out, and trying to edit videos is just not gonna work whenever I have a bunch of schoolwork. And I've just finished my first year of college, so that's a relief. And I also had to write some reports on some galleries, so this is all art that I saw. Yeah, it's super cool. But yeah, I'm very excited to have finished my first year of college and to, you know, have one chunk done. So yes, I will be posting regularly on YouTube again, probably at least once a week, maybe more, depending on how fast I can edit. Also, I forgot to tell you, I dyed my hair purple magenta, and I also have a mini art haul, like super small art haul of things that I got after I did my last art haul. So starting with these Royal & Langnickel Zen watercolor brushes, there are 5. They're like very fancy looking, but they're only $10. This Hanbei travel watercolor set, because I did set up a palette, but it's too big for me to travel with. This is a heavy duty X-Acto knife type of thing, because I had a cardboard project. And this is a brush pen. I can't remember the name of the company right now, wow. But I can put that up on the screen, I guess. And yes, so we're jumping right into the watercolor swatches. I actually filmed a review of these before, and it did not go, you know, like as planned, because it just took forever to film, and I thought the swatches looked really crazy, so I tried to make these swatches look better. So we're starting off with Cerulean Blue, and earlier I showed you a really crusty white because I did open up this watercolor set, and I had the white in my pencil case because it's very helpful for making your watercolor more opaque if you need it to be. And just now I was showing you that some of them have separated from their binder, so you just have to massage it a little bit and mix the pigment back in with it as best you can. So these reds right here, they look very similar on camera, and they also look very similar in real life. I don't quite know why there are so many very similar colors, but that is okay, because I like using red, so I probably won't run out. I mean, they're not exactly the same, so I guess it's good having them. The yellows in this set are like the most opaque and easiest to make washes with. Like, look at that yellow. That was just medium yellow, and it looks great. They're very vibrant. The white is also very opaque. On the paper in real life, you can see that it's like whiter than the page, but on camera you can't actually tell that much. Also, the cobalt blue and I think it's, yes, ultramarine look very similar too. So when I set up my 12 half pan set, I'm gonna have to decide which one of those I'm gonna put in. Woo! If you guys have suggestions about like 12 essential colors to have with you when you're on the go, please leave those below, because I am gonna have a hard time picking out what colors I will want in my travel set. I know that I'm probably gonna use Payne's Gray, which I will show soon. I've never had Payne's Gray before, but it's very nice. Like gray blue. It's nice. Very useful color that I actually use in the demo today. So I'm just gonna let you guys, finish watching the last, like, two swatches. Okay. And these pauses in the middle were actually me spreading the paint onto the top of the brush because I wanted to use them from a tube, not just from my palette, my dried down palette. So now we're on to the lift and bloom test. I used ultramarine blue as the lift test, and yeah, you saw me just squirt it straight onto the page, so it was a little bit more opaque. And then I used brilliant red and little dots of ultramarine blue for this bloom test, and look at that, it blooms really well. I'm not actually that surprised though, because I have used this paint like a little bit ago. And this is a brush from that Zen set. I'm actually going to do a full review of the brushes, so just hold on for that, buddies. It's a coming. yeah, now that I'm on summer break, I actually have time to, you know, make and edit videos. So, yeah, there's not going to be another month break between videos. So yeah, anyways, that brush picked up the color really well, and then, like, it lifts really well. And, like, I know this only, like, just dried whenever I actually lifted it, so maybe it wouldn't lift as well if the paint had set for, like, 24 hours. But, I mean, from experience of using this before, which I will, you know, make videos, or show you guys the videos of me actually using this paint, but from, experience, it does lift pretty well when you mess up and need to quickly fix your mistake. And basically I was just trying to make this heart very cute, but you can see a water droplet right there, so like as soon as I set the tissue down on it, the paint comes up right there too without me even scrubbing it. See that? Boom. Start lifting, and I think it lifts even more, which is, you know, a bummer because I was trying to be cute and put a little heart. But it's still cute, I guess. And now we're just sitting here waiting for me to zoom out and show you all the colors and give you a thumbs up, because I'm happy and I like all of these brushes. Now I'm taking that brush pen and writing the title of this stuff. This is a Pentel sign pen, of course. Yeah, that's what it is. It's a brush pen. And it was recommended, I've seen it recommended many a time in YouTube videos for people who don't have like good brush control over, like, you know, for lining and stuff. I thought I'd get it. Alright, now, let's make something now, okay? For today's video, I'm actually using my dried pan, which I did film the setup of, and I'll probably include in the video where I'm going to set up the smaller travel one. Just because it's fun, but I wanted to use this for this painting because I'm used to using dried down paint, and I wanted to see how vibrant the colors were if I just used them dried down. And for the drawing I used the Blick Studio HB pencil, and now I'm just erasing the lines around, and it's very faint, it's hard for you guys to even see what I did here. Alright, so I like pretty much used only the brushes from that set in this video because I was extremely excited and I've been waiting a while to actually film myself using them. I haven't actually used these brushes like before this video, so that was a very exciting thing for me. And since I haven't actually really painted skin tones for like a month, I was struggling, guys. I'm gonna be very honest, I was struggling. It's not because of the paint, because I've also tried painting with my Winsor & Newton Cotman paints that I've done a review on before. You can check the description box to see that. But yeah, I'm just not as practiced as I was a month ago. yeah, okay. I just need to practice skin tone, which I am happy to say I will be doing over the summer, because I will have time. And so I'm just laying down, you know, the skin tone that I mixed up, and just trying to add dimension to the face without making it very muddy. And I was on the verge of making it muddy, but to my surprise and happiness, I didn't mess up this painting and have to start the video over again and then postpone again. Yes, I'm adding red around the eyes. And that's Payne's Gray. The whole hair and her eyebrows and the shadows. It's all just straight up Payne's Gray. And I just was going around her face because she started to look quite manly, and there's nothing wrong with that. I just hadn't planned for her to, so I tried to go through and like feminize her face a little bit. You know, and I do that further with colored pencil near the end by adding like eyelashes and stuff. Oh, and just now I was showing off some of my ceramics that I made in school. Ceramic cup, because it dried out before I could put the handle on. And oh, I'm actually using that ink pen. I decided, like, this is a whole test piece. I might as well just go straight in with the ink pen, because I'm not very practiced with using or inking my art. So it seemed like a good plan to just go ahead and try, I guess. I didn't want to line everything with the pen, though, so I'm actually using a black prying pencil as well. I didn't want all of the lines to be so harsh, and now I'm adding eyelashes, of course. So, you know, going in with a red by prying to, you know, deepen her cheek blush and make her look cute. And going with a detail brush and the white. This is what I've been doing, guys. This is why this is so dirty. I've had the brush with me, and I'm just mixing it in with paints to make it more opaque, and also using it as highlight. Right there, it's better than gel pen, I think. A little bit more tedious because you have to have a small detail brush with you, but it works, you know, just as well. So I'm just finishing up details, putting on some gloss on her lips because that's cute, and highlighting where I think she needs highlighted. And yes, I do go in with the cheeks. See, because it's watercolor, you can actually blend it in with the paint that you've already laid down. Instead of having like a harsh gel pen line, that's, you can't really blend in. I guess that's the end of the piece, guys. Well, my overall thoughts are that I really like the Reeves paints. I recommend them highly. I recommend Prang, Winsor & Newton Cotman, and Reeves. They're very vibrant, they're very workable. You can dry them down into palettes. I got mine for only $10 instead of the original, like, $20. So, yeah. Thank you guys for watching. I will see you guys next week, or maybe in a few days. Bye!